So the detail is the makeover for the car. That's where a lot of the magic happens. A lot of people don't detail a car properly. Car detailing costs $100. Exterior, interior, engine compartment. Engine compartment, you pop the hood. You know, when you buy a brand new car, it looks all nice and shiny. 4 years later, it's dusty and mucky and just looks awful. Well, we're gonna take that awful look to a brand new look. Pressure wash the engine. You have to be very careful, you know, not to hit electrical components. You wanna pressure wash the engine. You wanna get off all the, you know, years of dirt and such that are underneath there. And then for all the plastics there, just like you spray Armor All on tires to make them shiny, you Armor All the plastic components underneath the hood, which there's a lot of. So you dress the engine. There's actually a product called engine dressing, not to be confused with Thousand Island dressing, but it's engine dressing that you put on there and it makes the engine look like brand new. First thing, pressure wash the outside of the car, trying to, you want to wax the vehicle, bring back that shine. A lot of vehicles here in Florida, there's stuff that falls out of the atmosphere called fallout, and it makes the paint look rough. If you have paint that's faded, a good detail can actually revive the paint again. Most important thing is all these headlights are made of plastic, and after 4 or 5 years, they start to dull and they look old. You can actually have a detailer buff the headlights just to bring them back. Plus, there's another process they can really make it look like brand new for the next 5 years. So buffing headlights, cleaning the engine, making sure the engine has been dressed and it's spotless, doing all these things to make a car look like brand new again. Because when somebody gets in that car, their first impression is like, it smells clean, it looks clean, it must be clean. But the nice thing about details is if you had somebody that crammed a chicken McNugget in the seatbelt, they'll get that out. I'm not digging chicken McNuggets out of cars. And the most expensive detail I've paid for is $250. And what that entails is more than just detailing. They'll physically unbolt the seats, unplug the electric from the power seat, remove the seat out of the car, they'll remove center consoles, they'll remove stuff. They'll take the carpet out of the vehicle, lay it down, pressure wash the carpet to get the major stains and stuff out, let it dry in the sun for like a day or two. If the seats were upholstery, they'll pressure wash the seats. They'll heavy duty, that's like a major detail that required interior components to be removed. That's getting, there's just a lot of man hours involved in that, so that's why it's 4 or 5 days for that type of detail. I had a matrix like that I had to do that to one time, but we turned the car from zero to hero in a matter of, a week. It looked from rough to, it came back to life. So after detail, then it's time to get the vehicle on the market. And this is the fun part, it's where Julie comes in. We take pictures of the vehicle. Pictures, just like videos, are worth 1,000 words. So I know my favorite place to resell cars is Craigslist. I use Craigslist. I can also use Facebook Marketplace. I can use OfferUp, use all these different venues to sell a vehicle. When I put it out there, Craigslist allows 24 pictures of a vehicle. I'll take 48 pictures of a vehicle because I'll do what I call the shotgun effect when we go to resell it. That's a whole other thing. So let me stick to the point. So remarketing the vehicle, taking the pictures, writing the ad is really important. Detail, detail, detail. When I write the ad, I don't write stuff that can be Googled. What I mean is this, a 2008 Toyota Camry LE, it came standard with power windows and power door locks and air conditioning and keyless entry and cruise control. All that was standard. I don't need to repeat that in my ad. What I need to say is no accidents, no smoking, no pets, no kids, no shit. I mean, the car is good. We want more history than, story. Then we want a story, we don't want facts. The facts, we know what the car came with already. Anybody can Google what the car is supposed to come with. But what you don't know is the last 5, 8 years, 10 years of its life, what has it gone through? So that's what you wanna sell when you go to resell the vehicle. Always try to find the ones with no accidents, try to find the ones that nobody smoked in. If it smells like, Great Dane's been living in there for 5 years, there's some dog smell that's impossible to get out. Those are things that people don't want when they get into a car. The story that sells, number one, is no accidents. People nowadays, so connected with Carfax, they want to make sure no accidents. They want to see that, they want to see a Carfax. They want to see that the vehicle was serviced at a dealership. They don't want to see that, like, well, my brother's best friend's ex-girlfriend's uncle aunt was a mechanic at Billy Bob's, you know, body shop. I think he looked at it a few times. They don't want that, dude. They don't want some driveway mechanic. They want the actual dealership to touch the car. So when they see the best story is no accidents, clean Carfax, meaning clean, it's been serviced properly. Someone that hasn't smoked in the car, if you're a non-smoker, you don't want to smell cigarette smoke the second you sit in the car every single time. And somebody that may not be a pet owner, someone that has allergies, may be allergic to pets, they don't want to get in there and it smell like a Great Dane. They want to get into a vehicle that feels like a brand new car. When they see and they get in, it's, this thing looks perfect, man. It looks gorgeous. When I resell the car, I fill up the gas tank. Somebody gets in the car and they see it's got a full tank of gas. Chuck will change the oil. It's got a sticker that says your next oil change is in, you know, 6 months or 5,000 miles from now. It makes them feel like they just bought a car at a dealership. And that's an experience when you go to resell it that anybody can duplicate. Just $20 for an oil change, $40 to fill up the gas tank, that's $60 that you just sold somebody $6,000 in confidence. $100 detail. I mean, these small things add up. And it just makes somebody feel so good when they get in this car and they're like, I'm not buying. In the old days, you know, well, you know, I don't want to sell used cars. I don't want to buy a used car. I don't want to buy somebody else's problem. Well, that's not the case. I'm not selling shit, so you're not buying somebody else's problem. You're buying a car that I hand selected to be a good car. I know this is a good car to buy.